guys, it's Brandon. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to be talking about all things feminine hygiene. I'm going to tell you my feminine hygiene routine and I'm going to be giving you some tips. I want to start off by saying I know that a lot of women don't have the privilege of having a bigger sister or just having a really comfortable and laid back relationship with their mom or older female figures. And that's the reason why I love creating content like this. I think it's really important for young girls to have some knowledge on how their body works, how to clean their body, the proper way of doing things. Because I've seen a lot of myths online on how you're supposed to smell, how you're supposed to clean yourself, and I want to make this video just to let you guys know that everything that you're feeling about your body is normal. You're not supposed to smell like flowers or roses. You're supposed to just smell like your body. I also know in a lot of cultures it's really taboo to talk about these kind of things, which I personally don't agree with. I feel like there should always be a safe space for women to come together and to talk about these things. So if you want to share any of your personal feminine hygiene tips or your personal routine, please comment that down below, because I just want to create a safe space for all women to come together and to be able to talk about these things freely. First thing we're going to touch on is how to wash down there. So basically, you need to know that there's a difference between your vagina and your vulva. Your vulva is basically what you can see on the outside. So your skin on the outside, so this is basically how like your vagina looks, right? So this is the skin, my palms, is what you're able to see on the outside. That is your vulva. The inside, like when you spread it open and when you open it, is your vagina. So there is a difference. You're supposed to clean your vulva, which is the skin you can see, and not the inside of your vagina. So I wanted to pop on here and clarify something that I didn't clarify in the video. So basically your vulva is your outer labia, your inner labia, your clitoris, and all of those things, right? So when I said vulva, I basically meant, and I didn't say it correctly, I meant only your exterior that you clean with soap and water. So your outer labia and like, you know, your butthole and things like that. Those are the only things that you clean with soap and water. Inside of your vulva, when you open it and you take it apart and you see your inner labia, your clitoris, like all of that, that is what you clean only with water, just water, no soap. So that is what I meant. I'm just saying this so I can put it in the edit and nobody will get confused. Okay, continue watching. So you're supposed to clean that like any other body part. I personally like using the Dove bar soap, and you can also get one for sensitive skin. It's literally just a bar soap. You're gonna run this through water and you're gonna lather your hands and you're gonna gently clean on the outside. If you're looking for something more pricey and more catered towards your down there area, you wanna use Honey Pot. I really like their sensitive foaming wash. First of all, because I have extremely sensitive skin. It's also pH balanced and you don't need a lot for it to have a good lather. Like, a lot of product comes out of this with one or two pumps. You don't want to scrub too hard. You want to be very, very gentle. Your vagina is basically self-cleaning. You don't need to put soaps inside the area. It can actually cause a yeast infection. It can really mess up with your pH balance. Never put anything scented down there. Even if you're not allergic to fragrance, don't use anything with perfumes. You can actually take your product and you can look at the back of it and you can just make sure that it doesn't have any perfumes, because you do not need perfumes in that area. That's really bad for you. Our areas basically have a naturally low pH, which discourages any growth organisms from entering our body. That is why there's no need to shove soaps, perfumes, anything inside of there, because it cleans itself on its own. I know sometimes I see a lot of questions about discharge. Like, some girls ask, oh my gosh, like I'm discharging so much, is that bad? Like, how do I stop it? Discharging is a really good thing. It means that your body is doing its work. It means that it is cleaning itself out thoroughly. You do not want to change it or try to stop it. The thing that you should do is just get some toilet paper, wipe it off. You could also like just grab your area, you can spread it open, and you can use your fingers to clean it out just with water, but that's the most that you should do. The only way you should be concerned about it is if it's colored. So if it's like brown, if it's green, that's when you should contact your gynecologist and figure out what's going on. But other than that, when it's normally like milky white, you don't need to do anything. So when it's textured or has a really odd smell, definitely start to contact your gynecologist. but I don't want you guys to think that you're supposed to smell like peaches and cream. You're supposed to smell like a body. And there's a common misconception that's like, oh my gosh, like I smell like this. Or like, I remember there was this trend where girls would like show their underwears and it would be nothing. That's not how a body is supposed to work. You're supposed to be discharging. That's normal for your body. It means that your body's doing the work that it should be doing. Another thing that you can do if you want to clean yourself out thoroughly, let's say that you're going to the gym or it's after special time with your partner and you want to clean yourself thoroughly, I really love these Honeypot wipes. And it's not only for your intimate parts, but it's for your body and it's also for your face, and you just pop it open. I think this is absolutely perfect for leaving in your car, leaving some in your purse, leaving it in your bathroom, like all that works pretty well. This is also plant-based, which is really good. All you have to do is take out a wipe and wipe front to back. If I'm facing this way, I would grab the wipe and I would wipe front to back, all the way back. All the way back. So that is basically what you want to do to clean yourself. You do not need all these special products. That is it. You want to keep your products non-fragrance. You want to keep them for sensitive skin. Another tip is to make sure you're getting out of sweaty or wet clothes as soon as possible. Like as soon as you can, make sure you get out of that. Bacteria can really thrive in moist environments. So you want to make sure you're thoroughly cleaning your body so you're dry all the way. Wearing cotton undies is also very important for keeping a healthy area down there. When your undies are way too tight fitting, let's say you wear a lot of thongs or just not cotton underwear at all, it can actually heighten your risk of getting a UTI. So it's important to wear anything breathable, or even when you're sleeping at night, not even wearing one is also a really good thing because it just lets your area breathe and just relax. Always, always, always regularly change your tampon. The general rule is every 4 to 8 hours, but you can always check the packaging of your tampon, your pads, your Diva cup, whatever you have, and just check when it says like the time frame that you can wear it. Don't exceed the time frame. Make sure you're taking it out when you're supposed to. When you're using the restroom, always remember to wipe front to back, front to back. You don't want to wipe back to front because you're taking all that gunk and you're putting it back inside of you. So wipe front to back, and if you can, thoroughly clean yourself with water. So how do you shave down there? I know that a lot of people actually have a lanolin and fragrance allergy that they have no idea about. I know that I have a lanolin and fragrance allergy because I've gotten a patch test at my dermatologist. And if you don't know what that is, you can bring in products that you know you've had an allergic reaction to. They test it on your back and you wear it for a couple of days and they take it off and it shows everything you're allergic to. So what I recommend for shaving creams down there is the EOS Shea Better Shave Cream. This is for sensitive skin. No lanolin, no fragrance. It also has natural shea. This has always done me well. I don't get any bumps with this, no razor bumps, no pimples, nothing. Like, this is absolutely perfect for shaving down there. It also has no fragrance. If you do have a shaving cream that you're adamant on using, please look at the ingredients. You don't want to put just anything down there. You want to make sure that you have something that's meant for it. When you're shaving, I don't recommend shaving top to bottom when you're shaving down there. Try shaving from side to side, like this. And the reason for that, like basically shaving like this, right? And the reason for that is that you can get a better and cleaner shave. Always, always, like let's say you have like a full bone bush, always trim yourself before you shave, because if you're not trimming yourself, hairs can get caught into it and it can clog up easily. So make sure you trim everything down first and then go ahead and get your razor and just shave side to side. After you're done, you can moisturize with either coconut oil. Coconut oil is a good one. I personally love rosehip oil because I found that it evens my skin tone and it just moisturizes me all day long. Any body oil that you want to use, you can definitely use. And remember, you want to do it on the outside where you can see your skin, not the inside. You don't have to spread your lips and put it on the inside of you. Make sure you only put it on the outside. So how do you get rid of odor? You want to always practice really good hygiene. Like I said, you want to wash the outside, not the inside. You always have to wash the outside. I shower twice a day, and that's how many times that I wash the outside of my body. And this is really important because you want to get rid of the buildup of dead skin cells on your body. You don't want it to sit there. When dead skin cells live on your body. Your body could have this weird smell to it, so you always want to make sure that you're washing that off. Like I said, don't ever use perfumes or scented soaps. Another way to get rid of odor is to change your underwear. If you normally wear satin, silk, or polyester, switch to 100% cotton. Cotton is 100% breathable and does a really good job at wicking away any sweats and fluids off of your body. You can also consider getting an over-the-counter pH product to restore your balance of pH down there. If you do try a pH product and it's the same or it worsens, definitely contact your doctor or gynecologist. Frequent hot baths or showers can also mess up with your pH balance. So one thing that you can try to do is soak in vinegar. Pour a cup or two of apple cider vinegar in your bath water and soak in it for 20 minutes. Vinegar naturally reduces bacteria. Overall, like I said, the only reason to make an appointment with your doctor is when you have a very fishy smell. Like when you're just relaxing with your friends or you're just at your desk and you can smell yourself, that is not a good thing. I recommend contacting your doctor to figure out what's going on. They can thoroughly help you with prescribing products that's meant for you. A foul smell can definitely be a symptom of a vaginal infection. So please contact your gynecologist if you feel like it's that bad. So itchiness down there can be a sign that you're using shaving products that you're allergic to. I recommend either switching to waxing or laser, either using a shaving cream that is for sensitive skin, no fragrance, no lanolin, and make sure that you're moisturizing yourself after you shave. If the itchiness continues after you do all of these things, you need to make an appointment with your doctor. The best way to prevent odors is to take probiotics. Probiotics are actually really, really good for you with maintaining your pH balance. There are probiotic-rich foods. Some of my favorites are definitely yogurt and kombucha. Staying hydrated is also super important. You want to make sure you're drinking enough water every single day. It keeps your whole entire body healthy. It also encourages healthy sweating and fluid release. If you're looking for anything over the counter for a yeast infection and you feel like you have one, I recommend Azo. It's really good for itching and burning, for odor and discharge, if you have it and you feel like, okay, I want to try this before I actually go to a doctor. So now that we've talked about hygiene, shaving, and odor, I'm going to give you guys 8 foods that will definitely help you smell good down there. Yogurt actually contains a bacteria that's naturally present in your gut, urinary tract, and vagina. This bacteria helps to restore a healthy yeast balance. It also prevents fungal infections. It gives you a healthy gut, a healthy vagina, and no foul smell. Cranberry juice or whole cranberries is really good for women suffering from UTIs. It's packed with antioxidants and powerful infection fighters. It helps to maintain a pH balance of your vagina. Pineapple is also a really good and well-known popular food product to eat. This is because it's really rich in vitamin C, vitamin B, and fiber. Not only do these nutrients improve gut health, but they also maintain a natural smell down there. It keeps it healthy and prevents infections. Apple is another food that you can eat. It stimulates your blood flow down there, keeping it healthy and fresh. Ginger tea is a really good drink that you can try. I personally love ginger tea and I don't even like tea. It promotes a healthy gut, a healthy vagina, and wards off any vaginal infections. Lemon is citrusy and works wonders. It has vitamin C and it's acidic in nature. This is exactly why it can help maintain your pH balance. Celery can help restore the ecology of your bacteria. The presence of chlorophyll in salad essentially helps maintain the smell of your lady parts. Cinnamon is also a natural spice that can help maintain a balance and a healthy smelling vagina. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Share this video for any girl who also needs some help. Comment down below your favorite tip or tips you're gonna try. I love you guys so much and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.